Respiratory arrest cases occur when a patient has a pulse but is not breathing normally. It's important to remember that agonal respirations are really not breathing. A reliable sign of inadequate breath is when breathing attempts do not produce a visible chest rise and fall. Respirations are effective only if enough volume of air is inspired so that oxygen can be circulated to the brain and vital organs, along with enough volume of air expelled so that CO2 is removed. Now, a key element for respiratory problems is to recognize respiratory distress and treat it early to prevent respiratory arrest. Signs of distress include pale, cool skin, changes in their level of consciousness or their level of agitation, increased respiratory effort, nasal flaring, use of the abdominal muscles to assist in breathing, wheezing, tachypnea, which is known as fast breathing, or bradypnea, known as slow breathing. A normal breathing rate for an adult is between 12 and 16 breaths per minute. Respiratory rates less than 6 breaths per minute require a provider to assist with ventilations, with a bag valve mask, a basic airway, or an advanced airway with 100% oxygen. Tools such as capnography and oxygen saturation monitors can help to determine if enough oxygen is being delivered to a patient. Now, although oxygen is important for a patient in respiratory distress or arrest, keep in mind that more is not always better. Excessive ventilation can be harmful by reducing venous return and decreasing cardiac output.